Square. There's a chance for the general public to see these race boats. And they're having a keen eye on John Watson. He is actually in bed one, which he got the title, the Southland Marathon, last year. Boat racing A class came third in the World Marathon held in Canada. We are all gathering at the YMAP ramp this afternoon after being hastily retreated out of the square this morning. Race boat here is John Clark's. The hull used to be owned by Noel Gray.
Watson and Green. Excuse me. How's it going there, Ray?
Well, Bruce, we're not sure yet. It's only Friday, what is it? Sort of just after lunch. We don't start until 2:30, but we've been for a run, and the boat seems to be going all right, so fingers crossed this time. We don't want a rerun of the 93 marathon where we had problems, but we'll be right this time.
Great. Oh, well, look, best of luck this afternoon.
Yeah, thanks, Bruce.
And Mr. Green, how's the motor going?
It's going to win this time. It's about 9,000 revs, and no, it's going well.
Good.
We're quite happy with
Day
1.
Okay, I'll see you at the end of the race. Good luck.
Okay.
Ian Coombs here. He's racing in B class, and how do you think you're going to go, Ian?
Well, our object this weekend is just to maintain consistently. We've had a pretty good run this season, and we'll just hang in there. Focus on not making mistakes and being consistent.
Yeah,
hopefully the time that I've spent on this in the last 5 weeks since the retired race will pay off. Gone over everything, and hopefully there will be no mishaps and no breakdowns. So our object at the end of the day is to finish, but we're not too worried about getting out there to win. We want to finish.
Great, well that sounds pretty consistent. What have you done to the boat?
This engine's now done 11 races since new. Decided it was prudent to pull it down, have a look. So basically, it's just had a bit of preventative maintenance in terms of crack testing, rinse and bearings, things like that. Jet units being looked at, then we can make a skin there and just tidy up in the hull bottom. And, yeah, it's as good as we think we can get it anyway.
Well, that's good, Ian, and it's just a long nose Impala with a delta bottom, isn't it?
That's right, it's an old 85 model Impala, old boat, but the engine's an HO350 Chev, which is just over a year old now.
Well, look, good luck, and I'll catch up with you at the end of the race. Okay, Paul, how's it going there?
Bruce, how are you?
Good, how do you think you're going to go?
Oh, awesome. Awesome. Mate, should I show you my excuse sheet?
Yeah, if you like.
Right.
There's a new boat here, it's called a Bravado 5.
You know.
And it's got a Jag motor in it, it should go pretty well. Is this the excuse sheet, is it?
This is the excuse sheet, to whom it may concern. We have listed the following in an attempt to explain why we did not finish in the top three of the 1995 Across New Zealand race. 1. Engine down 500 revs. 2. Only running on 10 cylinders. 3. Wrong choice of impeller. 4. Wrong choice of grill. 5. Stopped for an accident that didn't happen. Boat in front, not looking when we wanted to pass. Wrong choice of fuel. Wrong choice of navigator. Stopped for quick fish. Missed the shortcut. Wrong choice of droop snoop. Change that later. Down 600 revs after a slight miss in the ignition. Raining too hard in our part of the river. Helmet fogged up, never struck that before. Sucked weed and shingle on the start line. Blurred vision. Down 700 revs. Don't know why, never done that before. Finish flag further away than what we thought. Find any other excuse, not listed above. Absolute disappointment. It was doing 87 miles an hour on the trailer at the ramp on Friday. Don't know why it's not performing good.
Good luck.
It's got the smell.
You think you're going to go?
Three. I'm not going to go. No good, boss, if it's going to be flooded. Simple as that.
What's the outlook for the rivers?
Flood. Definitely going to flood.
Well, you've got the right boat for it, haven't you? It's a good...
For a wee sprint course, maybe.
Oh no, you'd have a fair chance at getting through this weekend with a good result. Good A-class boat like you, you've had some good results in the past.
Yeah. Have a look on the bridge tonight at 6 o'clock and we'll see how we're going.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you.
Warming up different boats, making sure that they're all running okay prior to the first part of the day. First race today is just a very short race up to the pylons from the Waimak Main Road Bridge. Got a minor problem with the battery. We've got Paul Curry here, he's probably one of the contenders in A-class. How do you think you're going to go this weekend, Paul?
Well, we're going to be happy if we finish, Bruce, but we should be in with a chance. If it stays rough, we might be right. The boat stays together is the main thing.
Yep, and I see you've got a new tow vehicle there. That should make all the difference.
Make all the difference, mate, yeah. Well worth the 10,000 trading offer that they gave me. Yeah,
it's a great. Very good. Yep. How's the boat going? What sort of motor have you got on this one?
Same motor, just a different bottom in the hull after major rebuild in Hamilton, so hopefully it'll just stay in the water.
Okay, well, we'll be at the top and good luck.
Yeah, mate, cheers.
Young Tim here. Tim's operating a B class. And how do you think you'll go, Tim?
Well, hopefully, after about 3 or 4 years, we might actually finish one race. We've gone from 55 back to 45. They told me to go as slow as I can and just get one finished. So just nice to finish one and keep up with the rest of them.
That'll be good. The rivers sound like they're going to be pretty high.
Yeah, most of them will be. This Waimak is a bit messy. There's 3 or 4 different channels and there's a lot of windy channels. There's no real straight stream, so hopefully half of them will get stuck and doing 45 I'll pass them.
Right. How's the boat going? You're having a bit of trouble with head gaskets and bits and pieces?
After buying every head gasket there was in New Zealand, we finally went to America and got some hopefully decent ones, so hopefully it will stay together.
Oh, good stuff. And you're running a Ford motor on this, aren't you?
I should be so lucky. Still the old cries this year.
Well, good luck. I'll try and catch you at the top of the race and we'll see how you get on.
Thank you, sir.
Ross, how are you going? Got some problems there, mate?
Yeah, I've got very shortly.
But once you get that sorted out, how do you think you're going to go this weekend?
Oh, top 10 maybe.
Oh well.
I'd like to be in the top 10.
Well, here you're doing 87 now on the clock.
Yep.
Oh, that's great. Keep it in the water. Good luck.
Yeah,
Scott and Neil Ross. Have a go at it. We're looking all right today. We can't guarantee the weather for the rest of the weekend.
Boom, how are things going and how do you think we'll go this weekend?
Oh, I think it's going good. Yeah, I think it's going good. Just got a bit more speed, but I reckon if we hang in there, we'll be sitting in the top three, I reckon.
Top three?
Top three.
How's the boat going?
Boat's not going very fast, but it's consistent, man.
You sound like you've got a cold.
I'm full of it.
Oh well, I'll keep clear of you. Good luck, Chris.
Thanks, man.
How'd you go, mate?
All right.
Yep. This afternoon's race on the WiMAX starts from the ramp to the pylons. This is a time trial run to determine the place of where you leave tomorrow, which is on the wire. They're letting the boats go in individual classes. Alan Ball being the only one in E class. These are all A class boats racing at the moment. Watch it. crikey. This should be John Watson, NZ1, racing Southern Stinger.
Bridge to bridge, Macquarie race.
tunnel. Today's conditions are clear and fine. There is a gusty northwesterly blowing. if they're over, you will incur a penalty. Like Dave Matheson, these are all C-class boats. Thank you. is Ray Watson. This is Bryn McCall. The boat's called Far Canal. All D-class boats now. If I'm not mistaken, this should be Noel Jeffries racing Buick. Racing a mono. Looking pretty good. Robert Hay, and boat is called Magnum Motors. I wouldn't think you'd have any trouble with the noise today, Robert. You're very quiet. This is Colin Smith. Colin Smith. This is Colin Smith. I wonder if he's still racing with Diesel.
Good fun, and best luck tomorrow. I'll catch you at the top of the wire.
Yep, that'll be good. If we get there, we'll see you.
Okay.
Okay.
On.
Slow, mate. Boat didn't quite ride yet.
Isn't it?
No.
What's the story? Is there some kind of handling problem or?
Slipping on the corners.
Is it?
So we're going home now to just rechange the grill, and we might see you at the bridge and we might not.
Oh, the bridge at the Wimac or?
No, the bridge tavern, mate.
Oh, the bridge tavern, okay. Hey, look, I'll see you at the top of the wire tomorrow.
Hopefully.
So we will see you there.
It'll be good.
The motor's going all right?
Yeah, the oil pressure's not 100%, but it's close enough.
Oh, good. Oh, well, you got one stage over.
Thanks.
Paul Curry just getting his boat on the trailer.
Oh! It only took us about 4 minutes.
Everything going all right? Everything going fine?
What's that, mate?
Everything going fine?
Still going all right.
Good.
3 hours to go.
Right? Forbes obviously had a clean run up. Good run up, Ross.
It was, yeah. It's a bit windy. Stay in the water. Yeah, no. A couple of you started.
You don't know how well that 400 is.
I think we had more touches on that bit than we had the last season's racing. Go across the... Oh, we'll get across there.
Shit, a navigator.
Sure, we got a lot more respect for the old ball.
Fine, thank you, sir.
John, how'd the flight go?
Very good, thanks.
Good. No head gasket problems?
No.
Great.
All the gauges are in the right place.
Oh, well, good luck tomorrow. I'll see you at the top of the wire, eh?
Thanks very much. Yeah.
Okay, any excuses?
No. Excellent run by me. Beautiful. Boat's handling really good.
Yeah.
Like it. Short run, but a lot of fun.
Yep, no problems, Paul?
None at all, mate.
Good.
Oh, the only problem I've got, this guy wants to go faster. He's beating me over the head. Faster.
Well, the bravado's certainly looking good.
Yeah. It's going good.
Good luck tomorrow.
Thank you, Bruce.
Oh, it's good.
You have a good run-up?
Yeah.
View number two. How did it go? You had a good run-up?
Oh, it was good. Yeah, no. Too short, that's the trouble.
No problems with the...
River was excellent.
No problems with the boat other than the crew?
Yeah, that's right. No, I think the driver was the problem today. Oh, got the rail back.
Hey, well, good luck on the wire.
Thanks very much.
Yep. Well, here's day two of the 1995 Cross New Zealand race, and we're just here at what they call the Leslie Hills Bridge on the Waiau River. River's up a little bit. They had a bit of rain last night up into the high country, but it's nowhere near what you'd call a heavy flood. So this is quite an interesting little spot here. We'll try and take a few shots of the guys going past. Hopefully there's no mishaps. They're a quarter of an hour late starting. Quarter past nine was the start time, I think. So should be through here shortly. Well, we've walked down to the river level so we can catch a look at some of these boats coming through here. Actually, it's not too bad as long as they take it slow. But there's going to be a few that won't. Spectators up here this morning. Absolutely beautiful morning here. It's blew you reasonably hard from the west, and there's probably 100 people, I guess, waiting around here to watch a few come through. Here's the first chappie coming. There's Kriji, third through. It's great. It's going well. Let's hope he slows down here though. Oh, it seems to be all right, but that gave us a bit of a fright. Oh dear, bit of a broken jet unit, perhaps. You can watch it later, fellas.
Hey?
You can watch it later. What happened there? Did you pop out and hit a rock? Just watch your back. Trying to get Kriji's boat out of the way here. Didn't get much of it on film because probably I felt like I should run. Here's Phil Kuzinowski, Kowzniewski. Stop filming and perhaps give these guys a hand. Have to grab the line. Grab the line, Tony.
Craig, don't go.
Did you get your gravel rash boat out, mate? Just in case. Because these guys are gonna have a problem. Come on, boys, come on, boys. Get that boat out. Oh dear, oh dear. Come on boys, on the bow, on the bow. Oh no. Well, they're out of the boat and they're all okay, so they're all right. goes nice and slow. Good stuff. So what do you reckon happened, fellas? I know this is probably not a very good time to ask you, but... what happened, Cridgey? Just got everybody else's rock.
Yeah, something else has got some paint on it.
Yep.
We hit it.
I think there's some people that have come through been quite lucky.
I would say so. Boat in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Well, I hope Colony and Tim are okay. They must be around the corner there, hopefully okay. Gary Love, slow it down, Gary. Uh-oh. Boat. Jet unit's just come right off. There's a Brimmer Court and he's seems to be taking it easy, which is good. Whoops-a-daisy, wrong line.
Wrong line.
Back on safe ground. A bit wet.
Yeah. Just a bit of short.
Yeah. Well, we'll give you a hand to get this boat out anyway.
Thanks.
And I guess a cold beer would be in order, would it?
Yes.
What happened, mate?
Not quite sure. I think we landed on a rock on the unit and broke the unit off, mate.
And she just filled up with water?
Filled up with water very, very quick. It's very hard to swim with a bloody crash helmet on. It makes you undo your bloody seatbelt before your boat sinks.
Yep. Oh, well, good. At least we'll get the boat shortly, shall we?
Yeah, it's tied up, so she should be right.
Oh, no, nobody hurt. That's the main thing.
That's the main thing.
Good night.
Yeah.
Oh, dear. I'm there, in the middle of nowhere. And we'll just be trying to find a way to get the boat out. Here we are trying to get hold of Tim and John's boat, and they've taken the bung out to see if the water will drain away. Otherwise we're going to have to tow it out.
Organised to pull the boat out. Around here. Okay. Sitting there. Waiting to be pulled out.
Thank you. We have it back on the trailer anyway, which is always a good start. Out of the race though, for Cobber Marine. And at least the guys are safe and sound and had cups of tea and warm clothes. Everybody's happy, so to speak. We'll go over and try and see what we can do with Cridgy. Tractor to pull out Cridgy and Colin Smith. Building so we can get the boats out.
It's running high and it's still coming through first. Watch it, Mike. Thank you. Golden Brim. You can make it.
Grey Leg, it's actually still in the Hara River, and they're just doing the briefing. 3 o'clock kickoff. We've lost two of the people that we've been following, being Tim and John Connolly, and also Stu Cridge and Paul. So we'll see how the others have got on. And how did you get up the wire, Ray?
Very roughly, Bruce. Very roughly. It was a very rough river. We handled it all right. Our boat, unfortunately, was bouncing and crashing around like most other boats. But yeah, we got there. But boy, I've never seen it so rough. And of course, we had to stop for Rob's accident. But that cost us about 3.5 minutes. We had a credit for that. So
right.
we're happy. We're running third in our class, and we're just cutting along. So we're looking for a good run today.
Boat and motor going well.
Yeah, seems to be, Bruce. Yeah.
Excellent. Okay. Well, good luck.
Okay. Thanks.
How'd you go going up the wire?
Terrible.
Was it?
No, it was terrible.
Did you have a few touches?
No. It's just too big of water in the gorge, I felt.
Was it?
Yeah. No, there wasn't a lot of fish in it, really.
Ah.
Yeah.
Okay, so you got up all right, though, and everything's going fine?
Yeah, no problem with the boat. No, it's going as well.
Good. Okay, well, look.
We won't take any chances.
Good luck on the grey. I'll catch up there.
At the end.
Good on you. Hurry, under the boat, cleaning out the grill. How'd you get on going up the wire?
Oh, terrible, mate. Well, we didn't sink it or anything like that, but we just couldn't handle the rough stuff. We just had it trimmed all wrong.
Did you hit that rock going through that rapid at Leslie Hills there? Any damage?
Did you hear me hit that, did you?
Oh, I think most people did.
No, there's actually no damage at all. It must have just clipped on the back of the unit here.
Oh, that was lucky.
I've got no marks.
Great. Oh, well.
I was just going too slow to get over it. I didn't really see it till I hit it.
Well, most of the guys hit it, so...
Oh, that makes me feel better.
Yep. Good luck. See you at the bottom.
Okay, mate.
Get on going up the wire, mate.
We made it. It was a prick of a river.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tony Ward sort of had trouble and wouldn't let us pass.
And you hit that rock going through that rapid at Leslie Hills there.
That was a good one, wasn't it?
Yeah, we got it on film, so...
Didn't hit a rock, though.
Was it not a rock, just a pressure wave?
Pressure wave. We slowed down.
Yeah.
Not enough, though, was it?
No.
Not like we slowed down enough, but we just sort of caught for the air a bit of pressure wave.
Oh well.
It's quite high, wasn't it?
It was high, it looked good. Yeah, yep, it gave everybody a bit of a fright. Everybody was starting to think they should run.
We were heading towards Coldham for a while, weren't we?
Yeah. Nicely recovered.
Yeah, well, I saw the video camera, so I thought I'd do something.
See at the bottom.
Right.
Right, how'd you get on going up the wire, Paul? How's this new Bravado hull handle?
Oh, beautifully. It was magic.
Was it?
Suited us down to the ground. Wonderfully.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
And you're going to have a good time on the grey?
A good time on the grey.
Well, look, we're going to shoot down the river and stop in a place where you're sure to clock it up, so We'll have some footage for that.
We'll put a show on for you, mate.
Okay.
Good day, Oscar.
Running medium to high. Overhead conditions are cloudy. John Watson first. Michael Hill second. Tony Ward. Kisnowski in B class. Whoa, whoa. Class. Ball. B class. Thank you. finish line on the grey lead, which is just in the inner harbour.
Shortcut.
Zealand 95, we're racing the Waimak River, the gorge, the ramp. Thank you.
fishing. Thank you.
Nigel, just...
Tony Ward will just follow. He'll just follow and follow and hope that they'll know in front of that sort of stuff.
Thank you. good man to know.
the Ray Watson, would it?
You've been done that.